In this video, we are going to talk about induction of label, that is called IOL. Now, what that mean actually? The normal labor is what? It should be spontaneous, as we have seen in the definition of the normal labor, that should be spontaneous. But whenever the labor is not happening spontaneously, or when we want to actually start the labor at our wish, we go for induction of labor. And how we do this? The indication of induction of labor are, the most common reason is post-dated pregnancy. It should be, it can be the pre-rupture membrane of the rupture of the membranes, premature rupture. When we want to terminate the pregnancy earlier, at even 37 weeks or sometimes even 34 weeks, because of the medical conditions like GDM, hypertension, oligohydramnios, not very assuring fetal status, or any liver disease, IHCP, intrahepatic cholestasis of pregnancy. In these all indications, we need to terminate the pregnancy at earlier, like 37 weeks or even earlier. So we need to do an induction of labor. Okay, now whenever you want to start a labor, you need two basic things. The first one is, you first of all, you need a very ripened cervix, means the cervix should be very favorable. And if it is not favorable, then you have to make it favorable. The second is uterine contraction, adequate uterine contraction. How we achieve these two objectives in induction of labor? Now, for cervical ripening, there are many methods of cervical ripening. There are medicines available and there are mechanical options also. The medicines preferred are prostaglandins. The prostaglandins actually do cervical ripening. Two prostaglandins used, PGE2, that is dinoprost, PGE1, that is misoprost. We can also do ARM, artificial rupture of membrane, that will eventually produce prostaglandin. So ultimately what we need here is prostaglandins. Now, mechanical stretching of the cervix, we can go for intracervical catheter dilatation or laminaria tent, that will go inside the cervix and just stretch the cervix. After proper cervical ripening, we need regular uterine contraction, and that we can achieve with the oxytocin. Okay, whenever you do IOL, remember my friends, it's not a normal delivery. Whenever you do induction of labor, it's not a normal labor. That means that it is a high risk pregnancy, and you need to strict monitoring, and you should have emergency cesarean section facilities available at any time, because any time the induction of labor can go worse, the fetal distress can be there. So only do induction of labor whenever you have the facilities of emergency cesarean sections. Or you can get the facilities within no time. Contraindications. What are the contraindications of induction? Definitely, CPD, malpresentations, placenta previa more than grade 2, fetal distress. All these are contraindications of induction of labor, and they are the indication of actually cesarean section. This is all about induction of labor from my side.